Alright guys, we're back in my garage, and today we're going to be talking about the issue with the AC blowing hot in your B58. Now this will apply to basically anybody that has a B58 engine, so even, you know, 340i, 440i, X models, Supras, anybody that has a B58 engine can potentially have this issue. Basically what happens is people say that the AC is blowing warm in their car, and I recommend that they go check their coolant levels. And sure enough, your coolant is going to be low in that tank. So you can fix it pretty easily. Obviously, just topping off your coolant, your AC will start blowing cold again. But somebody asked me why that is. And it actually took me a little while to find an answer to this. Shout out to Steven over at Wedge Performance. He gave me a lot of this information and helped me kind of start my research to understand how the system works a little bit better. So in this video, we're going to talk a little bit about how our AC system works, and why low coolant can cause your AC to blow warm, and also what you can do to help fix this issue long term. So let's go ahead and hop right into it. Now the AC system in our cars operates on pretty much the same principles as any other car. There are a lot of videos on YouTube that you can look up to explain exactly how an AC system works. And I don't want to go through all the details in this video just because it can kind of be a little bit confusing if I'm just explaining it to you. But the most important part that we want to understand can be explained pretty easily if you understand how a turbo works. So of course with your turbo, it sucks in cool air, it compresses that air, and that compression process heats up the air. Now after you've heated up that air, we want to cool it back down. So we'll pass it through a heat exchanger, usually an air-to-air intercooler, or in the case of a B58, we have an air-to-water intercooler, and that will cool the air back down so that it provides us with something that we can use. Now an AC system is very similar, except instead of just air that we're sucking in from the atmosphere, we have refrigerant inside of the AC system. And just like with a turbo, we are going to compress that refrigerant in order to increase the temperature. Instead of a turbo, we have the AC compressor that's attached onto the side of our engine. Now that AC compressor is going to heat it up, but we need to actually cool it back down. And through the cooling process, we can basically get it cold enough to where we can blow air over it, and that air will basically come out really cold from our vents. That's the AC that you feel inside of your car. So the first step to cooling the refrigerant back down is it will pass through a condenser at the front of our car, and that's basically just a heat exchanger, just like your intercooler. If you look at a typical condenser, air passes through the fins, and the refrigerant going through the condenser basically gets cooled off, and heat transfer happens in that process. Now in our case, BMW looked at that process and they said this is something, you know, fairly simple and has been working for decades, so we're going to make it more complicated. And what they did is they replaced that big condenser that mounts to the front of the car with a much smaller condenser that mounts inside of the engine bay. And it is actually an air-to-water intercooler, basically, or heat exchanger inside of your engine bay. And I'll show a quick video clip of where it's actually mounted. I saw this when I was removing the heat exchanger from my car during my heat exchanger swap. And I think I called it like an oil cooler because that's what I thought it was. But it's actually our AC condenser. So refrigerant comes in one port and comes out another port. And we also have coolant coming in one port and coming out of the other port. And so that coolant going through that heat exchanger pulls some heat out of the refrigerant and begins the process of cooling it back down. Now, you've probably guessed by now, but that coolant that's going through your condenser is the same coolant that is used to go through your intercooler. So if you ever have an issue where you have low coolant, a lot of times people see that it causes high IETs, loss of power, the car will feel a little bit slower, and in a worst case scenario, it can start to misfire because of the high IETs. But you can also experience hot air coming out of your AC because that coolant is not doing the initial process of cooling down the refrigerant that's coming out of your AC compressor. So if you're not cooling down the refrigerant, you're not getting it cool enough to have air that can blow over it and give you cool air in the car. And that's why your AC system seems weak. So hopefully you guys followed me through that whole thing. But basically, instead of a normal AC condenser at the front of the car, we have this small air-to-water condenser that's used to cool down the refrigerant in the AC system. Now, a couple questions that I want to answer about this. So first of all, that condenser uses the same coolant, but it is not in the exact same path as your intercooler. So if you actually follow the coolant lines on the different diagrams that you can find online, or even if you look at it closely inside of your engine bay, you can see that the coolant actually splits in the hoses. There's like a tee off. Half of the coolant goes through the AC condenser and the other half goes through the intercooler, and then it joins back together before it goes through the heat exchanger to be cooled down. So what I've noticed is that it shouldn't have a direct impact on your intercooler temps if you have your AC on or off. Also keep in mind that your AC system is supposed to turn off when you're at wide open throttle. So basically when you floor it, your AC should decouple and it should not put any extra heat into the coolant that's used in your intercooler system. Also, another thing that we kind of had a conversation about was with interchillers. And I know some of you have looked at interchillers and thought this would be a pretty cool option for us since we have an air-to-water intercooler. But you can imagine that basically the way an interchiller works is it uses some of the refrigerant from your AC system in another heat exchanger for the coolant in your intercooler. So in this way, it kind of would work a little bit backwards, or like in a big circle, where we're using the coolant to pull heat out of your AC, but then also using the AC to pull heat out of the coolant. It kind of probably would not work the best in our scenario. I haven't seen anybody actually try it, and I have heard that Interchiller is actually trying to work on one for our cars, and more specifically the Supra. So we'll see if that ever actually comes to be a thing, but I can understand why it's taken so long or why not a lot of people have done it, because the way our cars work, it's probably not the best setup for that kind of cooling system. So that's how all of this works. Again, just like with having issues with low coolant in any other scenario, you're gonna want to diagnose it properly. So figure out if there's a leak somewhere. The most common area to have a leak are the heat exchangers at the front of the car. The big one that's you're gonna see right in this grill area is the same heat exchanger for your intercooler circuit. So just look around for leaks, see if there are any wet spots or anything underneath it. You might not see a big leak right away, and you might need to pressure test it to find where the leak is. But I can guarantee you if it is leaking from one of the hoses or somewhere, even if you don't see it, it's just gonna get worse and worse and potentially leave you somewhere where you have no coolant at all. So double check everything, look at all of your fittings, your lines, your hoses, your heat exchangers, to try to find the leak and fix that as soon as possible so that it doesn't cause a bigger issue in the future. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do